السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So we have seen in our previous sessions, when we wake up from bed after sleep, when we wake up from bed, we should read one dua, one dhikr, that is
بسم الله الحمد لله الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور.
Then after that, we have read in another hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after waking up from bed, he recited the last 10 verses of Surah Ali Imran, starting with
نفي خلق
السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. Yes. Now, another hadith. So we should clean our hands or wash our hands before we dip it into any vessel. So soon after waking up from bed, after reciting Bismillah alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatna wa ilayhi an-nushur, if we dip our hands into any vessel, then before that we should wash our hands. It is sunnah. It is the hadith given in Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith number 162, under Kitab al-Wudu, Bab al-Istijmari Vitra, chapter, to clean the private parts with the odd numbers of stones. Under that bab, this hadith is given. حدثنا عبد الله بن يوسف قال أخبرنا مالك عن أبي الزناد عن الأعرج عن أبي هريرة أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا توضأ أحدكم فليجعل في أنفه ثم لينثر ومن استجمر فليوتر وإذا استيقظ أحدكم من نومه فليغسل يده قبل أن يدخلها في وضوئه فإن أحدكم لا يدري أين باتت يده. Narrated أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال Suddenly رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said إذا توضأ أحدكم, if any one of you performs ablution or wudu, then what he do? فَلْيَجْعَلْ فِي أَنْفِهِ ثُمَّ لِيَنْصُرْ, he should blow water into his nose and blow it out, or he should take water into his nose and blow it out. Okay, then وَمَنْ اسْتَجْمَرَ فَلْيُتِرْ, and if any one of you clean his or whoever cleans his private parts, so after urinals for example, then he should do so with odd numbers of stones, so till the cleaning is over. So if water is available, we should clean our private parts with water. If water is not available, it is permitted to clean the private parts with stone to absorb the urine. Okay, even if water is available, one can do it with stones, then after with water, after that with water. So if water is available, washing with water is must, compulsory. Okay, then وَإِذَا اسْتَيْقَظَ أَحَدُكُمْ مِنْ نَوْمِهِ, and whoever wakes up from sleep, whoever wakes up from his sleep, then فَلْيَغْسِلْ يَدَهُ, he should wash his hands, قَبِلَ أَنْ يُدْخِلَهَا, before he enter his hand into فِي وَضُوئِهِ, into the vessel meant for wudu, the or into the water meant for wudu. So okay, fa inna ahadakum la yadri ayna batati yaduhu, because certainly none of you may not know where his hand rusted during night time. So during night time we don't know. Our hands may have went somewhere. So sometimes in our private parts. So najas may be there. Okay, in our hands. So there is a probability. So if we wake up from our sleep during night time or morning, in the morning, then we should wash our hands before we dip our hands into water, especially if it is meant for wudu. Okay, then now sharah as given in Fathul Bari by Imam Ibn Hajar al Asqalani. قوله إذا توضأ أي إذا شرع في قوله إذا توضأ إذا شرع في الوضوء قوله فليجعل في أنفه ماء. So in one report, in some report, فليجعل في أنفه ماء. There it is. فَلْيَجْعَلْ فِي أَنْفِهِ مَعَا. So if any one of you perform wudu, then he should take water into his nose. Water. There, ma'an. The word ma'an is there. In some reports, the word ma'an is missing, omitted. Even then, the meaning is there. Meaning is that he should take water into his nose. That means to the tip of the nose. Then he should blow it out. So water can be taken like this, then you can blow it out. Okay, so this part maybe will be cleaned. Okay, tarab. No, qawluhu thumma liyantathir kadhali abi dhar wal asili bi wazni yaftal. Now in some report it is thumma liyanthur. So liyanthur or liyantathir, both means he should blow it out then. So after taking water into the nose, then he should blow it out. So liyansur or liyantasir. Both meaning, same meaning. Both have same meaning. Okay. Both words. Now, وَإِذَا اسْتَيْقَلَ أَحَدُكُمْ مِنْ نَوْمِهِ. If any one of you, it is that, if any one of you wake up from
sleep.
His sleep. So, قوله وإذا استيقظ هكذا عطفه المصنف واقتضى سياقه أن حديث واحد أنه حديث واحد وليس كذلك في الموطئ فقد أخرجه أبو نعيم في المستخرج من موطئ يحيى رواية عبد الله بن يوسف شيخ البخاري مفرقا وكذا هو في موطئ يحيى بن بكير وغيره وكذا فرقه الإسماعيلي من حديث مالك وكذا أخرج مسلم الحديث الأول من طريق ابن عيينة عن أبي الزناد والثاني من طريق المغيرة بن عبد الرحمن عن أبي الزناد. So here the part of the hadith starting with وَإِذَا اسْتَيْقَظَ أَحَدُكُمْ مِنْ نَوْمِهِ. Whoever wake up from his sleep, then that part of the hadith is given as continuation of the earlier part of the hadith by Imam Bukhari. But in some other hadith kitabs, for example in Muwatta, in Muslim, like that, this given. Then there, these two hadiths are given separately as two hadiths. Okay, so here the case of wudu, the case of istijmar, then the case of waking up from sleep, then after that washing the hands. These given together as a single hadith by Imam Bukhari. But in some hadith kitabs, وَيَسْتَيْقَلَ أَحَدُكُمْ, that part is a different hadith, separate hadith. So that is, the matter is given as two, the two hadiths. Content is same. Okay, content is same. Now, وَعَلَى هَذَا فَكَأَنَّ الْبُخَارِيَ كان يرى جواز جمع الحديثين إذا اتحد سندهما في سياق واحد كما يرى جواز تفريق الحديث الواحد إذا اشتمل على حكمين مستقلين Now, just as it is permissible to separate two independent parts of a single hadith with the two independent rulings. So, it is permissible to separate two independent parts of a hadith, a single hadith, if it contain, the two parts contain two independent rulings, then it can be divided into two or separated into two. Just as it is permissible, Imam Bukhari might have felt it is permissible to combine two hadiths with the same sanad or chain of reporters. Okay, so here he separated these hadiths, this hadith into two. This hadith combined this hadith, two hadiths into two. So, okay. Mustaqil. Hukamaini mustaqillain. Two independent rulings. Mustaqil means?
Independent.
Yawmal istiqlal. Today. August 15th. Huh?
Independence.
Independence Day of India. We were under the British rule. He got freedom from the British rule on 15th August 1947. So that day we call Yawm al-Istiqlal. This day is our Yawm al-Istiqlal. Yawm al-Istiqlal lana. Hada Yawm al-Istiqlal lana. That is for Indians, Hindi. Okay. Our Independence Day, August 15th. So Mustaqil means independent. Istiqlal means independence. Yawm al-Istiqlal means
Independence Day.
Okay. Then. Qawluhu min nawmihi. أخذ بعمومه الشافعي والجمهور فاستحبه عقب كل يوم عقب كل نوم وخصه أحمد بنوم الليل لقوله في آخر الحديث باطت يده لأن حقيقة المبيت أن يكون في الليل نو من نومه إذا استيقظ أحدكم من نومه is that if I got any error you should say okay is that the hadith استيقظ أحدكم من نومه okay then من نومه so here من نومه from his sleep there Imam Shafi'i and most of the scholars Jumhur means most of the majority of the scholars they took Imam, including Imam Shafi'i Rahmatullahi alayhi they took in the sense that all sleep umum that is this general, okay, generally, every sleep, every type of sleep. Sleep during daytime and nighttime. Daytime and nighttime. Any type of sleep or any type of sleep, night or day. Okay, then. وَخَصَّهُ أَحْمَدُ بِنَوْمِ اللَّيْلِ But Imam Ahmad, Ahmad bin Hanbal, rahmatullahi alayhi, he took it as the night sleep. Okay, night sleep because there is in the last part of the hadith batat yaduhu that part batat yaduhu okay yaduhu batat yaduhu you don't know where his hand rested that's why prophet has given a direction to wash the hands before putting it or dipping it into any vessel okay especially for the vessel or water kept for wudu. Okay, then. لأن حقيقة المبيت أن يكون في الليل. So, mabit or bata is related to night. Bata means to stay overnight. Okay, so there, in the from that part of the hadith, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal took it. the ruling is for the night sleep only. Okay. No. فَإِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَا يَدْرِي أَيْنَ بَاطَتْ يَدْهُ No. وَفِي رِوَايَةِ لِأَبُو دَاوُدُ سَاقَ مُسْلِمٍ إِسْنَادَهَا إِذَا قَامَ أَحَدُكُمْ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ وَكَذَا لِلتِّرْمُذِي مِنْ وَجِهٍ آخَرَ صَخِيهٍ وَأَلِي أَبِي عَوَانَا فِي رِوَايَةٍ سَاقَ مُسْلِمٍ إِسْنَادَهَا أَيْضًا إِذَا قَامَ أَحَدُكُمْ إِلَى الْوُضُوءِ حين يصبح لكن التعليل يقتضي اللحاق نوم النهار بنوم الليل وإنما خص نوم الليل بالذكر للغلبة نو no. In one report we see إذا قام أحدكم من الليل If any one of you wake up during night sleep or after night sleep, okay, and in other report we see إِذَا قَامَ أَحْدُكُمْ إِلَى الْوُضُوءِ حِينَ يُصْبِحُ. If any one of you wake up for wudu or ablution during morning, that is after night sleep, okay, now anyhow, from the mention of the sleep during night in the hadith, so here in the hadith night sleep is mentioned, it's okay. We can make it up, but we can make it applicable to the waking up from daytime sleep too, because the night sleep is particularly mentioned here. Just because night sleep is common or usual, usually sleep will be during night time, so that's why Prophet used such wording. Aina batati yaduhu. He don't know where his hands rested during night time. Okay, so though the hadith mentioned about the night time, it can be applicable to daytime sleep too, as Imam Shafi'i and most of the scholars have pointed out. Okay, then. Now, قال رافعي في شرح المسند يمكن أن يقال الكراهة في الغمس لمن نام ليلا. غمس means غمسة. Yes. Dipping into, yes, then. أشد منها لمن نام ليلا أشد منها لمن نام نهارا لأن الاحتمال في نوم الليل أقرب لطوله عادة ثم الأمر عند الجمهور على الندب وحمله أحمد على الوجوب في نوم الليل دون النهار وعنه في رواية استحبابه في نوم النهار. Now Imam Rafi'i explains in his Sharh Musnad that as the night sleep is prolonged, tul means prolonged. Night sleep is usually prolonged than that of daytime. Daytime sleep will be short period. Okay. When compared to that of daytime, dipping hands in the water before washing hands, in the case of a person who sleeps during night and wake up, then in his case, if he dips his hands in water meant for wudu or ghusl, then his karahat will be heavier than the karahat of the person who dipped his hands into water before washing his hands and he slept during daytime. So if one person sleep during night time and wake up and he without washing his hands, he dipped his hands into water, and other person also did the same but during that time, then whose karahat is heavier? The night times karahat is heavier. That means karahat will be heavier according to Imam Rafi'i. Okay. Now, most of the scholars say that washing hands after waking up from sleep is not wujub but mustahab. It is sunnah. It is recommended, highly recommended. Okay. But it is not compulsory at all. Most of the scholars' view is like that. But Imam Ahmad وَحَمَلَهُ أَحْمَدُ عَلَى الْوُجُوبِ فِي نَوْمِ اللَّيْلِ دُونَ النَّهَارِ. But Imam Ahmad rahmatullahi alayhi say that it is compulsory, especially during night sleep. So during night sleep, after waking up from night sleep, one must wash his hands. One must wash one's hands before he dip hands into water or vessel. Okay, it is a must. What is it? It is wujub, according to Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. But if it is during that time, he say wa anhu fi riwayatin istihbab fi nawm an-nahar, then regarding him or from him another report is there, it is sunnah during that time. So during night time it is wajib, and if it is that time sleep, then it will be sunnah. So according to majority of the scholars, it is sunnah during both day and night time. Okay. Then. Now, all scholars agree that if one dip his hands in water before washing, it will not make the water impure. But Ishaq, Dawood and Tabari say that it will make the water impure or najis. Here, the hadith speaks of about a doubt that the person would not know where his hand went or rested during night time. So it is a doubt only. It's not sure. So the person is not sure whether his hand is pure or not. So it is a direction to wash the hands. But it is not compulsory, because regarding a doubt, there will be no compulsion. There will be no compulsion at all. So most of the scholars say that it is only sunnah and not compulsory. Now also, they quote in the hadith of Ibn Abbas, you have seen earlier in the earlier session, that is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after waking up from the sleep, he recited 10 verses of Surah Ali Imran, then he went to the hanging water skin and took wudu. So there washing hands is not mentioned before wudu. Okay, so that is considered as a proof, or took as a proof by some scholars. Okay, now there are some scholars who oppose this view, because they say there is probability that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam washed his hands before going to the shanni mu'allaqah, that is hanging water skin, or taking bulu, before dipping his hands into that hanging vessel, okay, for taking bulu. He might have washed his hands. There is a probability, but not mentioned in that hadith, only that much. There is a probability. Now, or it may be the khususiyat or special feature of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Prophet's hand may not go in unwanted areas during night time, or Prophet's khususiyat may be. Now, another group, some others say Prophet might have avoided washing hands before taking wudu simply to show that it is permissible to do likewise too. So it is permissible, it is jais, to show that it is jais, it is permissible, Prophet might have avoided washing hands. So he might have directly taken wudu without washing hands. So that view is also there. Now, in some reports, including that of Muslim and Abu Dawood, we see فَلْيَغْسِلْهُمَا ثَلَاثَ فَلْيَغْسِلْهُمَا ثَلَاثَ, let him wash both of his hands three times. Here the number of times of washing is mentioned, and hence from it we may conclude that it is sunnah, as the occurrence of impurity or najas is not confirmed. Now, in one hadith of Abu Huraira, which is recorded by Imam Ahmad, we see فَلَا يَوَيَدُهُ فِي الْوَضُّوِ حَتَّى يَغْسِلَهَ, he should not put his hand into the wudu or the vessel or water meant for wudu till or until he washes it. Until he washes his hands. So only after washing he should put or dip his hands into water for wudu. Okay. So there the times not mentioned. Only washing is mentioned. Not thrice. In some hadiths it is thrice. So washing hands here is sunnah or recommended, and the person will get reward for that. And if one do not wash the hands, then it will be karahat. Or karahat means recommended to be avoided. It will be karahat. Now Imam Shafi'i says that the effect of karahat will be removed only by washing thrice and not less. So according to Imam Shafi'i, rahmatullahi alayhi, the person should wash the hands 3 times, not one time, once, not twice, but thrice, 3 times, okay? Then only karahat will be removed. فَلَا تَزُولُ الْكَرَاهَةُ بِدُونِ ثَلَاثٍ نَسْوَ عَلَيْهِ الشَّافِعِي. So Imam Shafi'i says that the karahat will not be removed unless the person washes his hands thrice. Okay? No. Here, kaff means, the yad here means, aina batat yaduhu, where his hands rested, you don't know. So, kaff, here yad means kaff, that is the palm, only that part, not this part, only this part may be washed. Okay. Now, some say, though it is sunnah to wash the hands before dipping it into water or vessel, then it is not karahat to avoid it. Though it is sunnah, to avoiding it is not karahat. They say that Abu Huraira used to do this, but he didn't find any harm in avoiding or giving up the same. Then, now in the report of Muslim and Ibn Khuzaymah, we see فَلَا يَغْمِسْ يَدُهُ فِي الْإِنَاهِ حَتَّى يَغْسِلْهَا. He should not dip his hands in the vessel until he washes it. Here, we may assume that simply dipping the hands in the vessel will not become karahat. For example, if one person, come on, adkhala yadahu fi ina'in wasi'in faghtarafa minhu bi ina'in saghirin min ghayri an talamasa yadahu al-ma'. If one person entered or dipped his hands into a spacious water, a spacious container or spacious vessel containing water with him in his hand a small container or small vessel, and by using that vessel he took water. Okay, so he didn't wash his hands before the wudu. He directly doing this. Okay, but his hand is not coming into contact with the water directly. Then it will not be karahat. Okay, follow? There is a spacious vessel, a big vessel. Water is there in it. Then a person, without washing his hands, took a small vessel, then took water from the larger vessel without touching in the water. Then it will not be karahat. Yes, say aloud. Then, no. Now here the words fi wadu'ihi. Wadu means the vessel meant for ablution, or water meant for ablution. Wudu. Wudu means ablution. Wadu means water using for ablution or wudu. Now here, see, the vessels for taking bath or ghusl also is like this. The hukm or rule is for that. Now the other vessels can also be considered in the same way. In the cases of other vessels, or vessels other than those vessels used for ghusl and the wudu, though it is sunnah to wash hands, it is not karahat to dip in such vessels. Okay, but to dip in vessels meant for wudu or ghusl, it is karahat to put into it without washing the hands. Okay. Now, la yadri, here, la yadri aina batat yaduhu. He don't know where his hands rested. The reason for the direction to wash the hands before putting it in the vessel is, why? What is the reason? There is a doubt that his hand might have come into contact with anything which may affect the water, which may contaminate the water. Hence, we can understand that if the person is sure where his hand rested and it is not impure, his hand is not impure, that person is sure, then there will be no karahat at all to dip into the vessel. Okay? To dip his hands into the vessel. For example, here one example is given. Come on. لَفَّ عَلَيْهَا خِرْقَةً مَثَلًا فَاسْتَيْقَظَ وَهِيَ عَلَى حَالِهَا أَنْ لَا كَرَهَةً. Then, suppose if one person took a piece of cloth, then wrapped his hand, then after waking up, he see the wrapping as such, not change at all. So he is sure his hand has not gone anywhere, or even if hand has gone, there is wrapping. So his hand is pure. There is no najis. Follow. Then for such person, dipping is not karahat without washing the hands. Follow. Assalamu alaikum.